And good evening, I'm Craig Cannon.
And I'm Angela Taylor, live from the University of Arkansas. Tonight we're updating you with the latest information following Coach Bobby Petrino's motorcycle accident. Take a listen to a 911 call made by a man named Larry, who was there just moments after Coach Petrino lost control of his motorcycle and then crashed it. We're also bringing you new pictures from the scene.
It's a motorcycle, a single vehicle accident, as near as I know. And the rider and the passenger of the motorcycle declined us to call 911. They got into a vehicle and headed toward the hospital.
Okay. Did they hit anybody else or somebody?
No, it's in the right of way.
What do you mean?
The motorcycle is here. The motorcycle's here on the right of way, and we're a little bit hesitant just to leave it here.
What kind of vehicle did they get into and leave?
It was a white SUV.
Did you witness the accident?
No, ma'am. I came by just after they were getting up out of the ditch.
Okay, and how badly were they injured?
It looked like his face was bleeding quite a lot, but both of them, she did not look to be very injured. She's the passenger. The gentleman was walking, mm-hmm. but it looked like his face was bleeding quite a lot.
How long ago did this accident happen?
Over 5 minutes, maybe 10. Robert and Rebecca Petrino was the name they're finding at the motorcycle.
The state police investigation into the crash has been wrapped up, but now investigators are looking into the way state police captain Lance King handled his response to Coach Petrino's phone call asking for assistance. Now, according to a release from Arkansas State Police, Captain King's supervisor asked the captain to give him a detailed summary of his involvement with Coach Petrino and other people who were identified and involved in the investigation. State police say they will share that information with the public early next week. And for the first time, we're hearing from the family who was first on the scene and actually picked up Coach Bobby Petrino and 25-year-old Jessica Durrell and took them away from the scene. Nick Williams, who's the father of Ben Williams, the man who transported Coach Petrino and Jessica Durrell from the accident scene, they're talking exclusively to 4029 News. Nick was present when his son was interviewed by Arkansas State Police and confirms that report is accurate. He says some media reported that Jessica Durrell was not in the car, and he says that's not true, that Jessica did leave with his son.
There was a little bicker there about who was going to call the state police. So, yes, there was a young lady in the car.
And it wasn't until yesterday that Petrino actually revealed that Jessica was on the motorcycle with him. Durrell, who was just hired to work with the football program, again, was a passenger. And I want to bring in sports director Mike Jocks. And Jocko, this is really what everybody on campus is talking about. We have cars driving by saying, free Bobby, Bobby. But of course, there are people saying, you know, he's not being a very good role model right now, and they don't care if he doesn't come back. So, extremes.
It's really an extreme. And everywhere I've gone today, I don't want to share too much of my life with you, Angela, but went to the grocery store and the gas station today, and everybody stopped me and they wanted to talk about Bobby Petrino. And everybody had a different opinion for sure. But today, the Hogs got back to practice as they hit the practice field behind me here at Razorback Stadium. And for the first time, they did that without head coach Bobby Petrino. Of course, he's been put on administrative leave. The Hogs are now being run by assistant head coach Tabor Johnson. Johnson led the Razorbacks out on the practice field. It's the first time, you know, that they're out there without Bobby Petrino. Johnson is in his first season at Arkansas after being hired as an assistant head coach. He also coaches the linebackers for the Hogs. He was hired on January 15th earlier this year. Johnson, of course, came to Arkansas from Ohio State, where he spent 5 years there. And, well, let's just say they're trying to keep it normal at practice.
Since Coach Petrino's accident, our main focus has been our football team. Throughout spring, our main focus has been the football team, so nothing has changed in that regard.
So it's been kind of a crazy week for the Hogs, to say the least, but hopefully once they get back onto this practice field today, they had a scrimmage as well. Things may return to normalcy, but I don't think that's going to happen for quite some time.
Did they talk about the focus of the players today? I mean, are they distracted at all?
That's what Tabor Johnson said was the one thing that stood out in his mind, that when he went in the locker room and talked to his players, that they were certainly focused on the task at hand and really proud of the Razorbacks for keeping that focus and continuing to improve each practice here in spring.
Yeah, sure. All right, Jocko, thank you. And of course, Jocko and I were just discussing how some people say, leave him alone, this is a personal issue, while others say he's supposed to be a role model for these students. And the students we talked to, some of the students we talked to at the University of Arkansas say that they're just upset because Coach Petrino kept this from him, from them, and he felt like he should have been honest from the beginning. Now, we know that Coach Petrino lied about having Jessica Durrell on his motorcycle the day he crashed. Durrell was recently hired by the university's athletic department to work within the football program. It wasn't until days after the accident that Petrino admitted to having a passenger. Petrino later confessed to an inappropriate relationship, and his delayed confession has students split on how they feel about it.
Hearing this, you know, it's definitely something you got to think about. It's no longer a question about, was he a good coach? You know, is he doing a great job? Because obviously he's doing a great job here, but it's a question about morals and ethics.
You know, do we keep our standard of football high, or do we keep our moral and ethical standpoint high? And so really, I think it was pretty selfish of him to do that.
Well, hopefully, like, the reputation of the school can kind of, like, overcompensate for what has happened, you know, because this is such a great school.
And 4029's Joe Ellison has been following fan reaction on the airwaves. She went to ESPN Radio 96.3 during the morning rush.
It's 8:30. You're listening to the morning rush on ESPN 96.3. And
I'm just a very disappointed and disgusted fan right now.
Fans were fired up this morning as they headed to work, turned up their radios, and called into ESPN.
Is in Westport. James, you're on the morning rush.
And he's still a human being. He's still just like anybody else.
We forget that sometimes.
Tommy Kraft took the calls and listened to what seems to be the most important part of the Petrino scandal, in the eyes of the fans, of course.
Clearly, Coach Petrino and the fans, there is a breach of trust. But at the end, I think the majority of the fans still want Bobby Petrino to be their head coach.
But Kraft wonders if they'll continue to do so.
As more information comes out, the barometer of how that changes will be interesting to follow.
It was asked of Jeff Long, three times last night, is this the only relationship that Coach Petrino has had, the only inappropriate relationship Coach Petrino has had?
Fans were talking about the man in charge of Petrino's review, U of A athletic director Jeff Long.
I would love to have been a fly on the wall and seen Jeff Long just tear into Bobby in his office last night. He made Jeff Long get up there and lie. And Jeff Long last night looked very upset.
Jeff Long was pissed.
Now those in the radio world and here in the TV world are wondering what's going to happen next.
Oh, it's going to be a great weekend to follow what goes on with this. That's going to determine obviously what happens Monday morning on our show.
Joe Ellison, 4029 News.
And Kraft said most of the fans he talked to said that they believe that Petrino should be disciplined, but they're also confident that he can lead the Hogs to a championship. Now, to read up more on this story, you can read the police reports from Arkansas State Police, and of course you can hear from Athletic Director Jeff Long as he addressed the media last night during a news conference. All of that is available right now on our website, 4029tv.com.